So, in this context, gravity is a very, very small and weaker phenomenon. It is a four major fundamental forces of the Earth. There are six cosmic ingredients or members of the cosmic society. One is prakriti or matter, shakti or energy, desha or space, kala or time, spirit or soul, which is the chetana, and consciousness or chaitanya. These six members are there, just as there are some members in the Jawaharlal Technical University and Vedanti Academy. The cosmic academy and the cosmic technical university consists of six members: the space, time, matter, energy, spirit and consciousness. So both of these sides, either going upon a metaphysical approach or physical approach. Metaphysical approach is an approach which is very much esoteric, in which a person surrenders to a particular concept, believes and then experiences, and even concept he experiences and then believes. So the experimental and empirical science of modern materialism that ask you to experiment, then experience, then believe and say it was. So here, believe in us, just as falling inside water, at least a limited water, is a requisite for getting the art of speaking. First, getting inside this art of spiritualism and surrendering to a person with a limited background is a primary requisite for getting a knowledge. Then only you can get the experience. So here, belief comes first and experience just. That the experience is based on a person's empirical belief. So both of these people, they derived to find out the behavior, origin, behavior and destination of these six units of the cosmos. This cosmic discipline or behavior is understood in different methodologies by different people. First, let us come to the four fundamental forces. One is the gravity, and second is the electromagnetic induction, and third is the nuclear forces being strong and weak in nature. So the infranuclear forces and ultra-nuclear forces, they form the fundamental, they are known as pillars of modern power, pillars of modern study of power. So the apprehension of power is based on these four major things. For this, now we have to take a religious scientific club. What we have already decided when we met at least 10 to 12 years before, that is already in the biostatistics and biodynamics of modern science. So, understanding not only the attraction of particles towards the earth, there are various types of understanding. Number one, agrogravity between all plants and their intersystems and related systems. Biogravity between the human beings. The psychogravity, attraction between minds. The ontogravity, understanding between the fundamental objects. Metagravity, understanding between superior and imperceptible objects. Astrogravity, gravity behind all actual objects, which is there in terrestrial mechanism. And geomaterial dynamics and teleparallelism. These are the new concepts of modern science. It requires a special analytical study, which cannot be summarized in a small inaugural address. So, studying about the biogravity, theogravity, geogravity, bigravity, antigravity, metagravity, paragravity, infragravity, ultragravity, and etc. are the new dimensions from our side. We have to throw more light upon the attraction of all particles. If there is attraction, attraction is on all things. And attraction gives us automatically repulsion. Motion is the basic cause of the birth. And there is nothing known as inertia. Even in inertia, there is a latent motion. So nothing is there which is wholesome, absolute inertia. Everything has motion. And the motion of a particular thing can be towards an object or away from an object. So away from an object is known as repulsion, towards an object is known as attraction. It is very common in science. And even in attraction, there are how many attractions? Attraction towards elements of same structure is homothetic attraction. With different structure is known as heterogenetic attraction. Attraction towards varieties object is polygenetic attraction. Attracting everything and putting control is known as ontogenetic attraction or omnigenetic attraction, which is given by God. So that is what we call as dharana and vidharana. The dharana is known as the control or withholding, that is between the equality of varieties of objects. And vidharana is the control on all objects by a single person, that is known as vidharana. I want to say about the cosmic withholding process of the Supreme, with some Vedic references to complete this session, inaugural address of this session. पति अजस्य नाभावत्ये कवर्तितं यस्मिन् सर्वाणि भुवनानि पत्युः. इज अ बेसिक सूत्र. सो फ्रॉम द ओरिजिन ऑफ ब्रह्मन, फ्रॉम द नेवल ऑफ द ओरिजिन ऑफ ब्रह्मन, ऑल पोजिशंस दैट आर टोल्ड, ही planetary system, solar system, galaxy system, cluster system and super cluster system, all these things are fixed upon the navel, nucleus of the navel of a single Aja, the originless Brahman. That is why God is known as Padmanabha, and that navel notice is said to be the nucleus of the same thing which I have told now. The hierarchy of this attraction is attributed towards the navel notice of the Padmanabha, the Brahman, who is metaphorically understood and metaphysically experienced by great converts of the Vedic religion. So the second thing is, there is a question in Vedas. Anabarne ime bhoomi yam chato sarodasi kim sitatram trabhukam yene mendri dhute kuhe ishwaha dhute bhoomi iti vatsasya vedhanam. This is a Vedic smita. The same question which Isaac Newton asked, that was also pondered by, pensively attempted by one more seer, a spiritual scientist known as Vatsa. He asked, Anavarne hime bhumi yam chatur charodas. Space is also withhold. If Earth is withhold like this, there is a controversial or contra-repulsive force which withholds the space also. Yava prithvi dhyam janayati deva ekaha. It is controlled by a single person, single personality of God. So here it is withhold by the force which withholds the sky also. Here it is a force of pull, and that is a force of push which makes both the things coexistingly possible to be in their orbits and respective status and strategy. So it has been asked by Vatsa, and he told Vishnuna Vidhute Bhumi, the all pervading Vishnu, the ubiquitous God, is controlling, withholding and mastering, holding this various strategy of universal status. So that was the answer. Vidhute. Vidhute means that is Vishikta Dharanam. Vilakshana dharanam, these dhrute. So what is the difference between this gravity and this type of gravity which is known as, this is known as dhrita and that is known as vidhrita? What is the difference between the dhrita's portion which is studied in modern science and vidhrita portion of the Veda? The dhrita simply says that it is withhold. Even when Isaac Newton, he wrote a letter to Dr. Richard Bentley, he told clearly, all universal planetary motions now have, could not have spring just from natural forces, but being impressed by an intelligent agent. So that is known as intelligent falling. The concept is known as intelligent falling, intelligent grappling, which is now Stephen C. Mayer, he wrote a detailed book on natural philosophy and the background of understanding the cosmic spirit. He has written a book, Stephen C. Mayer. And it has now been kept as even a syllabus in the course known as intelligent design, in which all the insentient beings like the space, like the limited sky and the planetary system, the earth including, all of these things are insentient, but still they are perfect, punctual and systematic in their self-axis rotation and also revolving around the sun in the orbit. So they must be designed, directed and delegated by a super cosmic brain. So that is an intelligent agent. So even Isaac Newton, he wrote a letter to Bentley saying that apart from the natural forces, I believe that there must be an impression of an intelligent agent. That intelligent agent, as Newton says, that as an intelligent agent, the Vatsa, a spiritual scientist, he clearly says that it is Vishnu, Vishnuna, Vishnu. That is all pervading Brahman. He holds everything. So the same philosophy of understanding an intelligent agent behind all the intelligent functions pursued by both of these people. Both are scientists. But the scientists, those who are in metaphysical and physical observation, that is it. So regarding this Vishikta Dharana, what is Vishikta Dharana? Number one, Sa Yeka Eva Karoti Iti Vaishityam. He, as a single person, he is doing that. So that is great. Number second, without the support of any instrumental benefit, or collective responsibility, or any other supportive responsibility, he is doing out of his own might. That is the second thing. Number three, he is holding with his compassion and mercy, like a mother. That is Damodara. He used to say that, Damodara. So that he holds all the planets in his cosmic belly. So he is a preserver of the world. Even at the time of dissolution, just as we, he in the pretext of creation we used to destroy things. God in the pretext of destruction.